EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us in the shadow of the Eiffel Tower in the fabulous European capital of Paris, France. Today it's week four and we've got what should be a great one here as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Aviators of Paris. The kicker, Chad Ryland, has this one teed up. And off we go from the City of Light. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. Oh, good return up past the 30. Past midfield. Devin Duvernay. One man to beat. And he will score. Touchdown, Ravens. And that right there is how you silence the home crowd.
All week long, in preparation, visiting teams talk about it. Okay, we've got to start fast. We've got to take the crowd out of it, as you just talked about there. We've got to control the ball early. And in this case, forget fast start. This is a blazing start. What they've talked about all week is their offensive unit doing that. Not necessarily the guys returning the opening kickoff, but believe me, they'll take this.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. And the Ravens lead at 7-0.
Makes the score, Ravens 7, Aviators nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, this defense for the Ravens, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Got a man and he hits him in stride. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 yards there, first down. Zero hesitation that time. That was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to him.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Yeah, look at this Baltimore defense. Yeah,
they've been very good this year against the pass, currently holding on to a top 10 ranking at number 10.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, it'd easily move into the top 5.
11 yards there, first down.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Looking to throw. Porter buying time to his left. Now the ball comes loose, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And now off to the races, down the right sideline. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. And that's a linebacker showing he can move pretty good with a football in his hand.
That's not just a short shuttle now. He took it and went a pretty good distance, didn't he? Did you get the 40 time on that?
I didn't, but he got 6 points out of it. I know that, and a great play for that defensive unit. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They find some open field here. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. It's a gain of 34.
Now that's a big-time run. Lightning in a bottle, forget it. He exploded out of the bottle for that type of a pickup.
Right back to him on first down. Travis Jones makes a tackle.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Here's second and 10. Operating from the gun, Porter. Now throw right side here, going to be incomplete. Hey, look at this Baltimore defense. Yeah, they've been very good this year against the pass, currently holding on to a top 10 ranking at number 10.
You have to like the way that they've played in the first month. They have to be very proud being a top 10 unit against the pass. Their goal, though, in this one, see if they can improve that ranking.
So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Off the play fake, Porter. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Two-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. 65 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Boy, some big runs here, Charles, already in this first quarter.
Yeah, the lanes are there. Go ahead and exploit them. But what I like the most, how decisive he is, putting his foot in the ground and going.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
They'll try to run this one in, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great effort there. His second rushing touchdown on the year, and the Aviators are back within a score. Extra point by Ryland, up and good, and that'll make our score 14-7. Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Throwing is Jackson. And that nearly an interception.
interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
On third down, Jackson eluding the pressure right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Facing fourth down, Baltimore will punt Jordan Stout out there. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Let's take it inside his own 40. Following the punt return here, there is someone shaken up. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. Just shy of midfield at the 48. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
From the 48-yard line, here's second and 6. Back to throw, Porter, and he's got his man in stride, complete, and he'll be brought down, it looks like right at the 40. That one, a first down pickup of 8. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it, and if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Now an open man. That's the tight end, Gesicki. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, and that will bring up second down. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is because you got to get his attention because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Ball on the 35. Here comes second and 5. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Through one corner, 14-7, our score. Second quarter down, it's our home team with possession as they've got it with a third down coming up. They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Hands it off out of the gun. Fourth down now after a loss of 2.
How about the job there on the outside? Shed the wide receiver and was able to make the tackle on the perimeter.
Here's Chad Ryland now on for the field goal. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now, let's find out who my playmakers are. get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better. Sometimes
it's
more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
Now it's Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And now it's 3rd and 3. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll try to run for it with Davids. Pushes him over. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have.
Right back to Dobbins on first. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last 2 snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I'd keep going back to him.
On 2nd down, a run with Dobbins. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10. As they've got things rolling on this drive. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. It's Marte Mapu. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. A free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle?
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. And his throw here is incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Complete pass on 2nd down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is 3rd and 10. Looking to throw. Porter. This one incomplete. Probably should have been picked. A little nonchalant with the throw to the safety valve, but it's 4th down. Here's Bryce Behringer now. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and the Ravens, they'll take over. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Jackson now.
A short throw caught by Andrews. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action.
It's hot! Report! Report!
Throwing now, Jackson on first down. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Again, Jackson escaping the pressure right. There he goes, right side. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first and 10, it's Dobbins. Up to make the tackle, J.C. Jackson.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
They set up the screen for Dobbins. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Brandon, how about that reaction there from a defensive end, able to recognize the screen pass trying to happen, broke off his pass rush, and then got back to tackle the running back. That's a very athletic and intelligent play. Reminds me of you working out and seeing that the treadmill's open and getting there before anyone else.
See, I know you're just patronizing me right now. Everybody knows at home that that is nothing but a shot at me, and I'll take it, absorb it, and we'll move on. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9. They're going for it with Dobbins. And some determined running there as he'll pick his way down to the 12-yard line. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll go again with Dobbins. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. They work now on second and 9. Now Jackson. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Well, we're trying to set up a screen there, but that one just too slow in developing.
Yeah, too slow in developing and well read, because that ends up being a bad feeling for the quarterback. He's got no blocking in front of him. His guys are just going to let defenders go, and they're coming for him. So if it's not there, you just got to throw the ball in the turf at your running back's feet.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. One touchdown is the difference. 17-10 our score, and we are back underway on EA Sports. The fair catch taken short of the goal line, and they'll begin this third quarter at their own 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline. That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Only able to gain a couple there, and that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
From the gun on 3rd down, Porter. He's got his target. That's complete. And look at the juice. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run. 34 yards.
Well, that was a pretty good time for his first catch of the ball game, and it turned into a huge play as well. He's certainly not been a central part of this passing game so far in this one, but he made his presence felt there. A big pickup on 3rd down.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. After seeing that, maybe time to go back to some downfield throws here.
Yeah, anything, change it up, because the teams that win, the best teams, they're the ones that make adjustments. Doesn't mean you can't come back to what you thought you could get done. Sometimes when you open things up a little bit, you can get back to what you wanted to do before.
So the completion good for 7 there, and it brings up 3rd and 5 now.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
They'll come up facing 3rd and 5. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. From the gun on 3rd down, Porter. And that is too far out in front. He couldn't haul it in. Incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that will cut this lead back down to 4 now. It's 17-13. So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got 3 there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Hold them. Let's get the ball back for us.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
No, we changed it.
They'll throw on 1st down with Jackson. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Again on 2nd and 10, it's Jackson. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. 1 incompletion, 2 incompletion. They're going for more.
From the gun on 3rd down, Jackson. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And he will have a Ravens 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down. And they're going to speed things up here. Jackson. No, he doesn't have it. Maybe some alligator arms there going over the middle. 3rd down.
Look at that opportunity for a big play across the middle. But he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Report! Third and two. Here's Jackson. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. It'll go as a sack, a loss of three, and in turn, it takes us to a fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. This is fielded at the seven. And he's out right at the 25. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the game.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. To throw on second down, Porter. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. A yard, all they need, but it's third down. On third down, they're going to run for it here. Nifty move, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 86 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. And they gave themselves options there on the third down play, and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
Right back to him on first down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Flush to his right, and he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Now a short one to Gesicki, and he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 25-yard line. 19 yards there on the catch and run. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Aviators have taken the lead here in the final seconds of the third quarter. Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that gives him a three-point lead. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And tackled at the 21-yard line.
negative there of 4 yards. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. Marte Mapu, the one to bring him down. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 10. Now it's Jackson. A short throw caught by Andrews. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
No, we changed it.
Here's Jackson to throw. Yet again, targeting and finding Mark Andrews. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Now Jackson on 1st down. Dancing to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there. And it's 2nd down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Here's Jackson. That's complete. It's Zay Flowers with it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 27 yards there, a 1st down.
And here we are in the 4th quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson, flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect. We'll try to pick up another 1st down.
Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down. They go back to the ground with Dobbins. All able to avoid him. And he's got this down to the 35. 83 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Hey, Ozzie, Ozzie, shut up. 13, 13, middle, middle.
Another run here with Dobbins. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another 1st down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Throwing on 1st down, it's Jackson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yes, let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They give him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Report.
Jackson looking to throw on third. That is caught and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Going to be stopped before he can get moving forward as he'll lose a couple back to the 5-yard line.
Well, that's a group that's well aware of what's going on the scoreboard right now. Excellent work by them to push them back. That defense, they want to make sure the worst they come out of this with is a field goal and a tie game.
Second down, goal to go. One more time with Dobbins. A good display of power, but ultimately it gets him just inside the 5 to the 4 and no further. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This crowd doing all they can. Here's third and goal. Jackson. Lots of screen pass. That's complete. Touchdown. J.K. Dobbins. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Ravens answered back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. Tucker with the extra point, and that will make this a 4-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And the fair catch taken. No time will come off the clock. And they will begin this critical drive at the 25-yard line. Here's first and 10. To throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him. They'll come up now. This is second and long. Back to throw. This one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that could be used against them.
They'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
We can make this one pretty simple. Rocked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
No choice but to go. Here's fourth down now. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Conley with a reception. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Final minute, one timeout remaining. First and 10. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
And that's into the hands of Gesicki. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So an ideal set of circumstances there. They move the chains, and they save that final timeout.
That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
Deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
What can they draw up now? Time to find out on a 3rd and 8. He'll look to throw. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And the Ravens have just about sewn up this football game. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game. But when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger. And dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So for Baltimore, they're...